JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for January the 14th. I am Haralambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar rebounded and traded higher against all but one of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday during the Asian session Thursday. It gained the most versus SEK, the Euro, NOK and NZD in that order, while it gained the least ground versus AUD and CHF. The greenback underperformed only against the Canadian dollar. The strengthening of the US dollar and the weakening of the risk-linked Kiwi suggest that markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. However, the relative strength of the loonie and the Aussie points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market appetite, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, most major EU and US indices closed in the green, with the exceptions being UK's FTSE 100 and Wall Street's Dow Jones, which slid 0.13 and 0.03% respectively. The positive picture rolled somewhat over into the Asian session today as well. Although China Shanghai Composite slid 0.91%, Japan's Nikkei 225, Hong Kong's Hang Seng and South Korea's KOSPI gained 0.85, 0.61 and 0.05%. It seems that investors maintained hopes over more fiscal support under a Biden presidency in the US, with the extra loose monetary policy around the globe also allowing buying of risk-linked assets. What may have also helped, especially yesterday, may be comments by Fed officials including Loretta Mester, Esther George and James Bullard, who pushed back the idea of the Fed tapering its QE program anytime soon. This means that the Fed will keep its monetary policy extra accommodative, even with headline inflation rising more than expected in December. Remember that the Fed wants inflation to rise above 2% for some time, so that it averages 2% over time. So with both the headline and core CPIs still below that mark, we stick to our guns that the Fed is likely to stay ready to do more if the situation suggests so. All this is in line with our view for higher equities and a weaker dollar in the first months of 2021. However, given the overstretched rally in equities, we cannot rule out a setback. Following the storming of the US Capitol, the House of Representatives voted yesterday to impeach Donald Trump, making him the first US president to be impeached twice. The Senate is unlikely to proceed with a trial before he leaves office, but even if he has left, a conviction could lead to a vote of banning him from running for office again. All this process may delay incoming President Joe Biden's agenda, which means delays in stimulus and spending plans. Concerns on that front may result in a pullback in equities, but we don't expect this to last for long, as we do expect more stimulus to eventually be unleashed. On top of that, we expect Biden to adopt a softer stance on global trade than Trump did, which could also benefit the broader investor morale. Now, as for today's events, the calendar appears very light today, with the only data worth mentioning being the US initial jobless claims for last week, which are expected to have risen slightly to 795,000 from 787,000. We do, however, have three Fed speakers on the agenda. Those are Chair Jerome Powell, Atlanta President Raphael Bostic, and Dallas President Robert Kaplan. Following comments by several of their colleagues against the idea of QE tapering anytime soon, It would be interesting to listen what these officials have to say on monetary policy. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.